I never set out to cover wars, but my father, who left when I was 6, was a soldier, and his father before him. My father fought on Iwo Jima in the Pacific, my grandfather in France. They were still teenagers when they went to war. I remember wanting to know why men go to distant places to slaughter one another, and how that becomes something noble. In 1987, photographing a fresh corpse for the first time in Haiti, there was this question that needed to be answered. A few minutes ago, this man was alive, breathing, going home to his family, working on his dreams for tomorrow. Now he lay dead on the pavement, and I wanted to know why. I thought my camera might reveal an answer. I've covered a dozen wars since then. Lately, I search for answers in far-off places like Baghdad, Tal Afar, Mogadishu, and Monrovia. I've met soldiers on both sides of the conflict, and civilians young and old caught in the crossfire. And I've seen the destruction and despair. People who've lost everything, who mourn for children, brothers and sisters, husbands and wives, fallen comrades. People ask how it affects me, and I can't really say. Change is hard to see when it's in oneself. The children still touch me, they still get under my skin. I know it's hard to be home now, it's easier to keep moving. Sometimes there's hope. There's rebuilding and preparing for a better tomorrow. Then the violence always crowds back in, a car bomb, an IED. I manage it better now, but the feeling of absolute heart-pounding terror never goes away. I find myself getting religion, swearing I'll never come back, and then as soon as I make it out, I start making plans to return. I don't know what it is for me, but sometimes back home in the States, I feel as if I'm standing on a beach and there are waves smothering me. Waves of advertisements for shit I don't need, of profiles of people who've never done anything except be famous, of politicians mouthing platitudes. And sometimes I feel like I can take just one picture and it lets me grab onto something that's real in this world. I'm 45 now. I'm the same age my father was when he left. Maybe I'm not that different from him. I know my limitations better. But his fascination with violence, his need to stay in motion, and his impatience with what passes for a normal life, I know these things have all filtered down to me.
overwhelmed.